Hi and welcome back. In the previous video, I show you how you can create this simple website using Gitbook. Now that you know how to use their web editor, we're going to enable sync with GitHub. I think that is an extremely useful feature because you're going to be able to sync your Markdown file that you have locally on your computer with Gitbook. And this integration, I think, is extremely powerful. So what we're going to be able to create at the end is something along the line of what I've already done for my website for the CBE Thermal Comfort Tool. So here, as you can see, I have my Gitbook website that I've created with the landing page, navigation, and so forth. And here I have all my Markdown files that I have synced with GitHub. So every time I change a file here, or every time I change the document using their web editor, I will be able to sync the changes automatically. So let's get started, but before we get started, I just would like to take a second to remind you to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you find this video interesting, and if you want to find out more and being notified when I release a new video, just don't forget to press the bell icon. So let's get started. So last time we created this space called YouTube. So let's open it again and check what is inside. So these are the files that are inside. So this time we want to share this file here with a GitHub repository, and we want to sync them. So the first thing that I would recommend you to do is to use any IDE of your choice. I'm going to use PyCharm in my case. Feel free to use VS Code if you prefer. The same thing will apply, and I will show you step by step how to do it via the terminal. So no worry if you're not familiar with PyCharm. We're going to create a new project. We're going to create it in Downloads, and we're going to call it YouTube. And then we're going to use a Python interpreter, which is Python 3.9, and we are going to create a main.py welcome script. I'm going to create a Python project. Doesn't have to be a Python project, of course. It could be a React project, it could be an R project, any project of your choice. In fact, you don't even need to have a project by itself. You can just have a Gitbook. However, I want to show you how you can organize very nicely and neatly your documentation if you have a project. Because there is one important step that we need to follow. So let me increase the font size. So here we have our Python project, which we have YouTube, which is the root directory, which we just created, and inside we have a main.py file. Okay, so there are a couple of things that we need to do. I'm sure you probably have already done it if you have a project that you want to sync with Gitbook, but let's do all the steps so all of you can follow along. The first thing that we are going to do is to do git init. And here I have the terminal open. In PyCharm, the terminal is here at the bottom, but you can also do it from the command line or from the terminal in Mac and just go inside the YouTube directory. So here we are, C, user, my name, downloads, YouTube. We're going to do git init. That's the first step. Then the second step, in my case, since I'm using PyCharm, I'm going to click new. I'm going to click on ignore files, and I'm going to create a git ignore file here. So here PyCharm offers me to use like some templates. So I'm going to select Python because it's a Python project and it's JetBrain. So it's going to not sync the .idea file, which is a configuration folder that PyCharm automatically creates. So we're going to generate this file, and inside here, the barebone file will only contain basically the file that you want to ignore. So in my case, this is done automatically by PyCharm. Then we are going to go here at the bottom and we're going to say git add dot, since we want to add all the files here. And we have actually the main file now that is going to turn green. So that's perfect because we want to sync that file. And the next step is that we have to move to back to the browser. We need to go inside GitHub here and create a new repository. Okay, to keep it consistent, I'm going to call it, actually it doesn't have to have the same name, let's choose another name, we're going to say gitbook-youtube. We're going to make it public, it doesn't have to be public, it can also be private, up to you. You're going to be able to sync it anyway, even if it's private. And here we're going to create a repository. We don't want to add a license, a gitignore, or a readme file, because we have already done that. Of course, in order to create a repository on GitHub, you need an account, and I've already logged in. So I'm going to create the repository, and I'm going to just copy the code that we have here. So we have a git remote at origin, and then we're going to copy this code here. Let's go back to PyCharm, to the terminal here at the bottom, and we just paste this one. Of course, we could have done it in another way via their git tool, but we're going to do it from the terminal so every one of you can follow along. So we're going to add the origin, and in my case, I don't want to change the name of the master branch. So by Historically, the master branch that was generally created when you initialize a Git repository was called master. GitHub wanted to change this name and call it main. So just keep in mind that if you change the name of the branch to main from master, then when we're going to import it in Gitbook, we just need to be considerate of that. We're not going to change the name. In our case, we're going to keep it a Git, call it Git master, sorry. And here we're going to do Git commit, and then we're going to say dash M, and we say first commit. So then the last command that we need to do is git push setup stream origin master, because what I told you before, we need to just make sure that we create this upstream called master. So we can press enter, and this is going to push our file to the GitHub repository. So the GitHub repository, as you can see right now, is empty, but if I refresh this page, technically I should see all the files. And as I said, ignore this .idea file, is not necessary. So this was the first step. Now, the next step that we need to do, and it is very important in order to keep our Gitbook file organized, is to add a gitbook.yaml file. In order to add the gitbook.yaml file, we just have to go back into PyCharm. Here we are, so we click here on YouTube, right-click, New, and then we're going to click File, and this file is called .gitbook.yaml, Y-A-M-L file. So inside this file here, we're going to add it to Git. From now on, I'm not going to use the terminal anymore to do the push. I'm going to use the PyCharm because I think it's easier, but I just show you all the steps and you can just do it from the terminal if you want. So I'm going to add, here you could have said git add and then the name of this file. But then what we need to specify inside this file here is root, and then we're going to say docs. Let me explain what I'm doing here. If you don't do this, if you don't specify that to Gitbook that the root directory is dot /docs, which this folder does not yet exist. When we are going to import all the things and all the files that we have here, basically, so in our project, so all these files here, all these files are going to go into the root directory, so the main directory. That is going to be annoying because we are going to see a lot of new markdown file here at the same level of our Python file. But we want to keep our documentation, or at least I prefer to keep my documentation nice and organized inside a subdirectory called docs. That's why I'm adding this YAML file here, because I'm specifying that the root directory for all the Gitbook file are going to be in the docs folder. So let me show you this. And we need to commit this change. So in PyCharm, I'm going to press Ctrl K, and then I'm going to press, like I'm going to say fit. I'm going to explain what I've done. So created gitbook.yaml file, and we're going to commit and push this change, which I can do in PyCharm with Ctrl Alt K, and then I can push these changes to the GitHub repository. So here, if I go back in here and I refresh, now we're going to see the YAML file that we just have added. Fantastic. If you can see this file here, let's go back to the online interface of Gitbook and let's do the last step. The last step is to click here on integrations on the left. We can see this toggle here, GitHub, so let's click on this. I'm going to list only public repositories because I created that repository to be public. However, if you created it as private repository, just click here on list repositories. I've already linked my account, my Gitbook account, with GitHub, so it's not asking me to log in, but in case you haven't done it already, just log in and follow the instruction on how to log in and how to sync Gitbook with GitHub. I'm going to click on list only public repositories, and I'm going to search for the repository that we just have created. So the repository is called Gitbook YouTube. Okay, we're going to press next, and here is what I mentioned before. So if you kept the name master, is by default sync master branch only. Alternatively, you have to click here and you have to put main if you call it main. Okay, but we are going to keep it sync master branch only. We are going to press next. I write my content on GitHub or on Gitbook. Well, we started our project on Gitbook, so we're going to select the second option. However, no one stops you to write the content first on GitHub. But in this case, we have already started our project on Gitbook. So next project, you can start on GitHub. But in this case, we have already started this one, so we have to select the second box. Please keep in mind that this is very important to understand. It's just for the first synchronization. Later on, you can work either on their web tool or you can use you can work locally. So I'm going to click here, next, and this is setting up GitHub integration. So let's see what it's doing. It's exporting the content. That's what we want. Fantastic. So now it's ready. We can just go outside. We can go back here, Git book, YouTube example. We can do a refresh of this page here. And as you can see, we can see the docs folder. We have a README file and a summary file. And inside here, we have our group, which was contribute code of conduct. And we have some Git book assets, which is our image. So that's great. We were able to import all these things. The last step is to go back to PyCharm. In PyCharm, I could do git pull. I'm going to do Ctrl T, which is going to merge incoming changes into the current branch. I'm going to press OK. Let's go here at the top and let's view the project. So here, what are these files? The two most important files that you need to know is the README, which is our landing page in Git book. So this is the landing page. And we have summary. Summary is the table of content that you can see on the left. So let me show you what do I mean with that. So if I go here on Git book, we can see that this is the landing, this is the table of content on the left, and this reflects exactly what is in here. We have an initial page, code of conduct, index and guides, code of conduct, index, okay? So this is what we have, and inside here we have guides. But then here inside initial page, we are importing the readme.markdown file. And if I open this file here, I have, sorry, not that one, this one here. We have initial page, introduction, and then this text. Let's go back there, and we can see that the initial page is introduction, this text, and the subsection. Now, let's see how we can work from one side or the other. So let's start with the local repository. We want to change this text because it makes no sense, okay? The other thing that we want to add is another group. So we are going to create a new directory inside here. We're going to call it Getting Started. And I can just use dashes, Getting Started. So I'm going to create here a folder. Inside the folder, I'm going to create a new file and I'm going to call it intro.markdown. So we are going to add it to Git. This is a very nice functionality of PyCharm. And we're going to call it intro to getting started, and here inside we can write how to get started. Of course, I'm not going to go too much into detail because I just want to show you the gist, and then of course you're going to be able to change that yourself. Before we commit this change and we push it to GitHub, we need to be very careful that we add this new group and this new file inside here the summary. So how can we do that? Well, we can just copy what was done here. So let's just copy here, and we're going to say here, we're going to call it Getting Started. And here we're going to call it Introduction. And here we just have to refer the file of the Getting Started. So where is the file? It's in getting started/intro.markdown. So now we're ready to go. We do Ctrl K in my case, which would be commit the changes and push. Of course, you can use the terminal. So let's do Ctrl-Alt-K. Actually, let me change the commit message, create a getting started. And then Ctrl-Alt-K, we are going to push these changes to the GitHub repository, and we can go back here, and we should be able to see that this page will automatically refresh. Fantastic, as you can see, it was in real time. And we can see getting started, and we have the introduction, how to get started. And then I can change this file here with Git book. Of course, I can click on save, merge, and if I go back here, and if I go into intro, and I do a Ctrl T, and I merge the incoming changes, and I press OK, we should be able to see the new commit we save with Git book. That's great. So we were able to do everything, and we were able to sync the two projects. Now, it's just up to you to change the documentation as you please and as you want. As you can see, you can use their online editor or GitHub, whatever you prefer. I just have one final recommendation for you, is that if you want to just write headings, if you just want to write text, that's super simple. You can just use a simple syntax in Markdown. And if you're using, like for instance, PyCharm, PyCharm helps you, because as you can see, you can convert the text to italic, or you can put strike through, or you can put code, and so forth. However, GitBook uses a flavor of Markdown for other things. Let's go back to the README here, where we added an image, okay? So the image, actually, there is nothing strange, but let me show you later on how to add a video. I would recommend you to add a video link from their web tool, understand how they import the video, and then later on you can also add a video here locally. But let me show you that. So let me add first another image. So I'm going to download an image and put it here. So I can go to Unsplash here. I'm going to pick the first one. Doesn't really matter. It's just to show you how to do it. So here we are saving into the load and we're going to call it image. We are going to save it in docs here. So here I can open in Explorer. So here I have my file. I can go in downloads and then I can get this image and I'm going to change the name image. I'm going to press Ctrl X and then I go back to the previous directory. Here we go to docs, we go to Gitbook assets, and inside here we're going to put the image. Now that we have the image, we can go back to PyCharm. We can copy this code here if you don't know how to add an image, otherwise you could have just simply write it, and we can go here in the intro in how to get started. In order to add an image, or let me show you, actually is a exclamation mark, and then you have square braces, and here we have the alt text. Here I need to go one level up, and then I need to use Gitbook asset image.jpg. Let's see if everything was successful. So we can go back here and we should be able to see the image if everything worked fine. One last thing that I haven't shown you how to do it last time and I want to show you this time is how, for instance, to embed a video. So I'm going to get a video of my own. So we can go here, we just have to paste the link of the video and automatically you press enter and Gitbook will add a link to your video. We save, merge, and then we go back to PyCharm, Ctrl T, and we are going to be able to see all how to add a video into Markdown using Gitbook. So this is how you can embed a video. So let me just remove that. So you have to use these curly braces, percent symbol, embed, and then we have URL, and then we just need to put the URL of the video. I really hope you find this video interesting and useful. If you did, please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. It really helps. If you also want to find out how to create a website, a documentation website with another tool like Docusaurus, I will put a link to Docusaurus down in the video description and you should be able to see a card here at the top. If you want to support this channel, you can do so by buying me a coffee or supporting me on Patreon. More information in the video description below. And thank you very much for listening and see you in the next video.